The logical place to discuss SAFE is from the beginning, S. So S stands for Setup for Safety. And when we think about setup, we're thinking about that both from a human resource perspective and from an actual physical resource perspective. So human resources would be all of us, the dental team. So part of Setup for Safety is making sure that every member of your dental team has the information that they need to help be part of this process and preventing jams. That includes the person in your office who answers the phone, who might take a new patient phone call and can ask pre-screening questions before they get onto the schedule. To the same person, or maybe a different person, is going to interact with patients on the phone after an appointment. That may be because they're proactively doing follow-up phone calls to check and see how a patient is doing, or because a patient calls in saying, hey, here's what I'm feeling. Is this something that I should be worried about? So those folks need to know to listen for the things a patient will say if they're starting to experience jams, and how to ask questions that the patient may not be giving voluntary information about. The same will hold true for every member of our team. So that's our dental hygiene team, our dental assisting team, and of course, all of the doctors in the office. So we really suggest thinking about how we get this information to our team members. That's one of the things these videos are for, is you can invite your team to come on and to work their way through these videos. You can also do it in a more structured format and set up a team meeting or a team training time, and you can go through the videos together and have a chance to dialogue. But we want to make sure that every member of the team knows, moving forward, jams is part of what we do in our office. We're going to screen and treat, and we're going to use SAFE as part of that protocol. The other part of S, or Setup for Safety, is making sure that we have all of the tools we need so that we can be part of preventing and treating jams in our practice. Those could be simple things like range of motion guides. We're going to have a little video on how to do that. It could be having QuickSplints in our office. It could be making sure that we have processes in place to schedule those appointments that are long enough for patients to have rest periods. So as we go through this, one of the things to do as you watch the videos is to start to make yourself a list of things that you might need to acquire as you want to implement this in your practice, or conversations that you need to have with your dental team to make sure that we have the JAMS protocol in place in your practice moving forward.